Starting things off with some controversy, Netflix has recently added the French film Mignon, also referred to as Cuties, to their queue. The film's writer and director, Manuel de Corée, describes it as a coming-of-age story from the perspective of an 11-year-old French Senegalese girl going through a culture shock of acquiring social media attention through dancing. A perspective piece from the Washington Post by Daniel Dresner highlights partial cleavage and uncomfortable directorial emphasis on the young girl's posteriors, while also calling out figures such as Ted Cruz that are critical of the film's content without having watched it. The film won Sundance's 2020 Directing Award, along with procuring three other nominations. Continuing on the theme of shocking reveals,
well, guys,
Avengers star Chris Evans
studio.
Is making headlines for his NSFW Instagram post over the past weekend.
No wonder I can't hear
Evans went on the Tamron Hall show to address the controversy, thanking his fans for being so supportive. Quoting Evans, it was a very interesting weekend full of lessons learned. You got to roll with the punches. Evans used the media attention to his advantage by tweeting out,
the show's over.
Now that I have your attention, vote November 3rd.
What does this mean?
Coming fresh off an impressive Oscar run in 2019, starring in the new Christopher Nolan movie Tenet and back and forth production on the latest Batman movie due to COVID-19, Robert Pattinson is stealing the spotlight again in his latest film, The Devil All the Time. The movie, having been released on Netflix 2 days ago on September 16th, showcases Pattinson as an antagonistic West Virginia pastor at the end of the baby boom era in 1965. Opening reviews from Rotten Tomatoes describe its dark content as harrowing to the point of punishment. Between a 3 a.m. study break and editing in the studio, I was able to witness its content, and it definitely earns its R rating. The film also stars Tom Holland, Bill Skarsgard, Sebastian Stan, and more.